market. Wall Street was easy street for everybody. Brother, you can't lose. And speakeasies full of false values. We were unprepared for reality. Panic gave way to despair. Overnight, the richest country in the world had spawned bread lines, soup kitchens, and apple sellers.
Paramount. Wall Street. The business of America is business, announces the new president, Calvin Coolidge, to which the people reply, keep cool with Coolidge. And the sound of the stock ticker begins to dispel the woes of those who were hurt by the post-war recession and those who lost their shirts in the Florida land boom and bust. As Will Rogers tells it, people wire in, buy me some stocks. The brokers answer, what kind? And the buyer wires back, any kind the Republicans are in, ain't they all supposed to go up? Hallelujah, hallelujah, shoo the clouds away. To the bulls operating on the stock exchange, the elections mean 4 more years of prosperity. Americans have become fearless speculators, living in a make-believe world, getting rich quick without working. As Mr. Coolidge turns over the reins of government to Mr. Hoover, he announces that things are absolutely sound and stocks are cheap at current prices. Don't sell America short. Why, man, we've scarcely started. From Boston to San Francisco, the market is the national mania, the biggest news of the day, every day, coast to coast. And what quotation? Steel up, utilities up, motors up, radio way up, everything up, up, up. What difference does it make if you buy a railroad stock such as Seaboard Airline and think it is an aviation corporation, as long as it goes up? Buy on margin. Brokers' loans are available. All you have to do is have 5 cents for a telephone call, and you can even get that on credit. Just buy. Buy on margin. Everyone is doing it, and everybody is getting rich. Why not? Everything is going one way, and one way only. Up, 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 and up. Production, sales, bank deposits, brokers' loans, stocks, especially brokers' loans and stocks. Up. Even the Illuminati dropped Freud in favor of electric bond and share. Let's do it. Let's do it. Birds do it. Bees do it. Even educated fleas do it. The bulls are loose and pawing the ground. 4 million shares a day. 5 million, 6, 7. That's nothing. Nothing can arrest the upward movement, say the oracles. And the Secretary of the Treasury has predicted the high tide of prosperity will continue. What more do you want? 300 million shares are being carried on margin. Brokers' loans are at an all-time high. But don't worry. The values must be there somewhere. The market is not only discounting the future, it's discounting the hereafter. September 1929, soaring out into the wild blue yonder, stocks hit what looks like a permanently high plateau. Now here's a tip. Some of these prices will look ridiculously low in a year or two. New York swelters in a severe heat wave, but that doesn't stop anybody. Sure, there are technical readjustments once in a while as the lunatic fringe of margin speculators is being shaken out. But conditions are fundamentally sound, aren't they? October, Indian summer, 1929. The day has come. Not so gradually, not so slowly. The market goes up a little, then it goes down a lot. In the decade of bad taste, in the revolution of manners and morals, the bears finally jumped the bulls. It's over. All over. over here. Here in Wall Street, the oracles still sound off. The technical readjustment and the market rallies. Stocks always go up, don't they? Down go the common stocks. Down, down, down they go. Tuesday, October 29th, 1929, in history's worst panic, over 16 million shares are dumped on the market. Over $14 billion go with them, and so goes the confidence of a nation. Wall Street lays an egg, and so do the 20s. The greatest gaudiest spree in history is over. The people have had one too many. Margin? More margin? There isn't any more margin. Hallelujah. The jazz age is over, all over.